हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू द न्यू मिसलेनियस एक्सरसाइज 5B. सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी हैव सीन द मिसलेनियस एक्सरसाइज 5A वेयर वी हैव सॉल्व्ड ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द टॉपिक वेक्टर्स. सो दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट वेयर वी विल बी लुकिंग एट द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ वेक्टर्स टू द ज्योमेट्री. ओके, सो विदाउट एनी फर्दर डिले लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज लाइक दिस. Using a vector method, prove that the perpendicular bisectors of the sides of a triangle are concurrent. Okay, very good. So our first step is what? We will follow the same approach. Whenever I display the question, you please pause this video and let's try to prove these things. Okay, so let's have a triangle here. First triangle ABC. So let's say this is A, this is B and C, and let me have the perpendicular bisectors here. So this is what we have, perpendicular bisector. Okay, so here it is one perpendicular, this is another perpendicular, as well as the bisectors. Okay, so as well as the bisector means what? This part is equals to this, this is equals to this, and this one is equals to this. Okay, and let's name this point as a O point and have the bisectors as they are bisectors. Let's name these as the D, E and F. Okay, so this is what we have. So what we have to prove that these are the OE, OF and OD are the concurrent. They are intersecting at a point, that we have to show. So how you prove this? So let first have the position vectors, required position vectors. So let A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar, E bar and F bar be the position vectors of point A, B, C, D, E, F respectively with respect to O. Okay, means what? We will be having the vectors like OA, OB, OC, OD, OE and OF. Okay, so these are the position vectors. As what are these points? DEF. DEF are the midpoints of BC, AC and AB. What you can write? How you will write D bar is equals to what? D bar is equals to B bar plus C bar by 2. And we have already seen this is in the internal section formula. E bar is equals to A bar plus C bar by 2, and finally we have F bar is equals to A bar plus B bar by 2. Okay, so as these are the perpendicular, see OD is perpendicular to BC, means what? The OD bar dot BC bar, their dot product should be equals to 0. Okay, so as we have from figure what we have is OD bar and BC bar are perpendicular to each other. Okay, therefore definitely we will be having the dot product of these two equals to 0. So OD bar dot OC bar is equals to 0. So OD bar is nothing but a D bar, so which is a D bar dot B bar is nothing but C bar minus B bar is equals to 0. So let's have solve this. So we will be having D bar is what? D bar is nothing but B bar plus C bar by 2. So it is B bar plus C bar by 2 dot C bar minus B bar equals to 0. So let's simplify this. So if I multiply throughout by 2, I will be having B bar plus C bar dot C bar minus B bar equals to 0. Let's open the bracket. So B bar dot C bar minus B bar plus C bar and minus C bar dot B bar, it is equals to 0. And in the dot product, the commutative law is applicable. So, b bar dot c bar and minus b bar dot c bar can be cancelled out. So, remaining is what? C bar is equals to b bar, which implies that c square is equals to b square. This is our equation number 1. I hope it is clear. Okay. Now, once you have OD and BC perpendicular, now let's try to have, see, what we have done is, we have seen OD and BC perpendicular this. Now let's prove the same for OE and AC. So let OE and AC will have the same part here. From figure, OE and AC are perpendicular to each other. Okay. From figure, OE bar and AC bar are perpendicular. Okay. Means OE bar, you will be having what? OE bar dot AC bar, it is equals to 0. What is E bar? E bar is A bar plus C bar by 2. So let's substitute the value. So it is A bar plus C bar by 2 dot C bar minus A bar, which is equals to 0. Okay, so multiply throughout equation by 2. So you will be having A bar plus C bar dot C bar minus A bar equals to 0. So A bar dot C bar minus A bar plus C bar minus C bar dot A bar equals to 0. Commutative law is applicable in this dot product. So we'll have C bar equals to A bar, which is equals to C square is equals to A square. This is equation number 2. Samajh rahe? Okay, perfect. Samajhna hi chahiye. Okay, so from equation 1 and 2, what you can say, boss? C square is equals to B square and C square equals to A square. Kya baat hai? Okay. So from 1 and 2, what you can write? C square is equals to B square and which is equals to A square. Therefore, B square minus A square is equals to, directly likh diya humne. So B square is equals to A square. Okay. Which can be written as like this. See here. Which is B square minus A square equals to 0. So that can be written as like this, B square B bar minus A bar dot B bar plus A bar, yes or no? So it is A minus B and A plus B, A minus B, A plus B whole square. See here, A square minus B square ka formula kya hai, aapko pata hai na, A minus B and A plus B na, that's why. Okay, so the same part I have written here, in terms of B square, vectors. Okay, so now dividing the 2 on both sides, what you will get? B bar minus A bar dot B bar plus A bar by 2 equals to 0 by 2, which is becomes 0. Yeh 0 by 2 becomes 0. Okay. Now, if you observe, what is this second part is? What is this part is? This is nothing but A bar plus B bar by 2. What is that, boss? This is A bar plus B bar by 2. Very good. Okay. So, what you get here is B bar minus A bar means nothing but it is AB bar dot, what is this? This is F bar. F bar means what? It is equals to 0. Implies AB bar dot OF bar, it is equals to 0. Means what? AB bar and OF bar is also perpendicular. This we have proved. Dekho bhai, we have taken these two for our calculation and with the help of that, we proved that the third one is a perpendicular bisector. Okay. And in all these three, this O point is same, which is a common. That's why I can simply conclude that all the perpendicular bisectors are concurrent. Here, O is common to all perpendicular bisectors. Therefore, for any triangle, perpendicular bisectors always concurrent. Always concurrent. And what is this concurrency is known as? By perpendicular bisector rahega to unka wo point ka naam kya hota hai? Do you know what is this point is known as? This is known as a circumcircle. Circumcircle. Okay. Okay, very good. So in the theorem part, so in the exercises part, we have seen what is the in center, what is the centroid, and what is the orthocentroid. Now we come across this fourth center of this triangle, which is nothing but the circumcircle. So I have given you a very best, very explanatory video. Please look at that video and you will be understanding the difference between the circumcenter, in circle, then centroid and the orthocenter. I have also explained this Euler's line of the triangle, which is a very, very important. You will love that video. Okay, so please go through that video. The link will be providing below in the description box. Okay, theek hai. So I hope the first question is very clear. Very good. Now let's see the second question. What the second question says is, in ABC, if ABC is a triangle, okay, if ABC is a triangle whose orthocenter is P, whose orthocenter is P, and the circumcenter is, and the circumcenter is Q, okay, no problem, then prove that QA bar plus QB bar plus QC bar equals to QP bar. Okay, so to solve this question, we should first understand what is the orthocenter and the circumcenter of the circle, sorry, of the triangle. Okay, and I hope by this time you have seen the video in which I have explained you in detail about all the four centers of the triangle. Okay, so if you have not seen, please go through that video. So let's draw a figure here. So let me have one triangle ABC. ABC, okay, A, B, and C. So what this says is, okay, suppose if I have one line here, this line is Euler's line. Okay, I have explained you what is Euler's line in the last video. Please go through that. In the Euler's line, we have the three points which are collinear. So the first one will be the orthocenter. So this is my orthocenter. And in this case, the orthocenter is nothing but a P. So let's name this point as a P. After that, we have a centroid. Okay, let's name this point as a G. And after that, we have the point circumcircle, which is given in this question as a Q. Okay, and on this Euler's line, the centroid G divides the segment PQ in the ratio 2:1. Always remember. Okay, agar aapko ye concept pata hai na, to you can solve this question. Bahut aasani se solve hoga bhai. Dekho kaise. Okay, so you know what is G is. G is the centroid, and it is dividing the segment PQ in the ratio 2:1. So as G bar divides segment PQ bar internally in the ratio 2:1. So what you can write down, G bar is equals to what? Dekho bhai, PQ ko divide kar rahe ho and in the ratio 2:1. So you will be having cross multiplication. So 2Q bar plus P bar divided by 2+1. And what is G bar is? G bar is nothing but the centroid of a triangle, which is given as A bar plus B bar plus C bar divided by 3 equals to 2Q bar plus P bar divided by 3. So these 3 and these 3 can be easily cancelled out. Okay, so what is remaining now? A bar plus B bar plus C bar. A bar plus B bar plus C bar equals to 2Q bar plus P bar. So next, what can be done? So what we have to prove, that QA bar, QB bar and QC bar equals to QP bar. Okay, so let's have minus Q, minus Q, minus Q. See, on this LHS side, I want 3 Q's. Okay, so let's subtract 3 Q's from this side. So a bar plus b bar plus c bar minus 3 q bar, okay, let me have small one, minus q bar equals to 2 q bar plus p bar minus 3 q bar, subtracting 3 q bar from both sides. Okay, so you will be having a bar minus q bar first part plus b bar minus q bar plus, okay, what you want is q, okay, that is okay. So next is what, c bar minus q bar, which is equals to c, we will be having p bar minus q bar. So what is a bar minus q bar is, this is nothing but q a bar plus this is q b bar plus this will be q c bar and this will be q b bar. That's it. This is the only thing we want to prove here. Q a, q b, q c equals to q p. Q a, q b, q c equals to q p. Okay, so if you know the concept of Euler's line, you will get this question in just a minute. Okay, very good. So if you have not seen that video, please go through that video. Third question is like this. So third question, if g1 g2 are the centroids of a triangle abc and pqr, if g1 g2 are the centroid of triangle ABC and triangle PQR respectively, then prove that, respectively, then prove that AP bar plus BQ bar plus CR bar, it is equals to 3 g1 g2 bar. Okay, so let's try to solve this question. So what is given information here is g1 and g2 are the centroids of a triangle ABC. So what will be the g1 bar? G1 bar will be equals to what? It is the centroid of triangle ABC. So it is a bar b bar plus c bar by 3 implies a bar plus b bar plus c bar, it is equals to 3 g1 bar. Next, g2 bar will be equals to what? It is p bar plus q bar plus r bar divided by 3 implies 3, okay, we'll have the same pattern here, p bar q bar and r bar, which is equals to 3 g2 bar. Okay, now let's take these things AP, BQ and let's take the LHS. LHS, so LHS will be what? It is AP bar plus BQ bar plus CR bar. Now let's simplify this. AP is nothing but P bar minus A bar plus Q bar minus B bar plus R bar minus C bar. So if I take P plus Q plus R on one bracket minus A bar plus B bar plus C bar in another bracket, what you will have? So this is nothing but 3 G2 bar minus this is 3 G1 bar, implies if I take 3 common, I will be having G2 bar minus G1 bar, which is equals to 3 G1 G2 bar. Okay, so I hope it is clear to all of you. Very simple. Now next question. Let's see the next question. The fourth question is like this. Let's have this statement here. Question number 4. Okay, if DEF are the midpoints of side, if DEF are midpoints of sides BC, CA and AB respectively, of a triangle ABC, okay, but obvious, of a triangle ABC, and if G is the centroid of a triangle, and if G is centroid of triangle ABC, then prove that I hope you are following the same strategy. Pause the video and try to prove these things. Prove that DG bar plus EG bar plus FG bar equals to zero. It is both obvious, okay? It's very, very simple. Now let's see, what is the first step? Try to have a figure. Okay, so let's have the triangle here. 1, 2, 3. Okay, triangle ABC, ABC. Okay, D is the midpoint of BC. So this is the point D. E is the CA. This is E point and this will be F point. Okay, and G is the centroid. So this point somewhere we have the G centroid. Okay, so from the given information, what we can write? D bar is equals to B bar plus C bar by 2. Okay, perfect. E bar is equals to A bar plus C bar by 2. Oh, very good. And F bar is equals to A bar plus B bar by 2. And finally, we have the G bar, which is centroid, which is nothing but A bar plus B bar plus C bar by 3. Now take the LHS of this given. So let's take the LHS and let's substitute the values. LHS, which is nothing but DG bar plus EG bar plus FG bar, which is equals to 0. So this is nothing but G bar minus D bar minus D bar. See, only the small concepts we are using from the topic vector. Okay, all the small, it is not a rocket science. Very simple. So G bar minus E bar and G bar minus F bar, which is equals to, okay, equals to 0, that we have to prove. So let's take G bar, G bar, G bar becomes 3 G bar minus, if I take common, I will be having D bar plus E bar plus F bar. Okay, now if you add these three things, D bar, E bar and F bar, what you will get? So it is 3 G bar minus, so let's add this. D bar is nothing but B plus C by 2, B bar plus C bar by 2, plus E bar is A bar plus C bar by 2, and plus F bar is A bar plus B bar by 2. Okay, so next thing what to do, solve the bracket. So this is equals to 3 G bar minus, so if you see here, we have denominator same, so you can easily add the numerator. So we'll be having B plus B, which is 2 B bar plus 2 C bar and plus 2 A bar upon, we have 2. So simply we can cancel out numerator 2 and the denominator 2. So you take G bar minus 2, take common, which is, so denominator 2 bahir, B bar, A bar and C bar. Okay, so this 2 cancel. So what is remaining? So what is 3 G bar minus A bar plus B bar plus C bar, A bar plus B bar plus C bar. And what is this A bar plus B bar plus C bar is? This is nothing but, here if you see, this is nothing but 3 G bar is equals to A bar plus B bar plus C bar. So if I substitute that value, what you will get? 3 G bar minus 3 G bar, this is equals to 0, which is nothing but our RHS. Hence proved. Very simple. Now let's see the next question. Question number 5th. See, this topic is very simple, boss. If you know the small concepts, that is sufficient. The question number 5th is, if A, B, C and D are 4 non-collinear points, non-collinear points in the plane such that AD bar plus BD bar plus CD bar, it is equals to 0, then prove that the point D the point D is the centroid of a triangle ABC. Okay, if you see the previous fourth question, this is the same thing. See, DG, EG and FG equals to 0 bar, where G is your centroid. Okay, अभी इसमें उन्होंने ये दे चुके ऑलरेडी AD, BD and CD equals to 0 bar. Then we have to prove that this D is what? It is a centroid. See, one and the same. ये सिर्फ उल्टा उल्टा है. The fourth and fifth are what? They are the vice versa to each other. Corollary you can say. Okay, so let's prove this. No need to draw any figure here, because just simply simplifying this LHS, we can prove that part. So LHS, which is equals to AD bar plus BD bar plus CD bar, which is D bar minus A bar plus D bar minus B bar plus D bar minus C bar. So D 3 times A, so it is 3D bar equals to 3D bar minus, if I take common, I will be having A bar plus B bar plus C bar. This is equals to, okay, so ये क्या हो गया 3D bar, it is equals to A bar plus B bar plus C bar. So 3D bar क्या हो गया, the D bar will be equals to what? It is A bar plus B bar plus C bar divided by 3, which is nothing but the centroid of a triangle ABC. Centroid of triangle ABC, hence proved. Is it okay? So equals to 0 bar diya tha unhone, 0 bar, 0 bar, 0 bar. Okay, hence proved. Very simple. Okay, so with this we will stop here. I hope you have understood each and every question from this. Please do not skip any question here, because all the questions are very important. And remember that we are using only the simple concepts. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. So we will meet in the next video. Thank you.